Today, I have the second installment of the series of InDesign Basics brought to you by Satori Graphics. We're looking at the essential tools of InDesign in this InDesign tutorial. How's it going, everyone? Did you have a great weekend? We're kicking things off this week with an InDesign tutorial on the essential tools of Adobe InDesign. In the first episode of InDesign Basics, we looked at the setting up a poster for print in InDesign. Today we delve into the essential tools of the powerhouse software. Firstly, when you import something in InDesign, it may seem blurry. This is probably due to the default preview setting of InDesign not being set to high quality. You can change that here. You can access the toolbar like so, and then click to change its layout in this manner. First, we will look at the two selection tools. You will realize that they look similar to the selection tools in Adobe Illustrator. And also, you should note that every single tool in the toolbar has a keyboard shortcut to access it. The black arrow tool, aka the selection tool, is used for editing and moving frames. InDesign puts everything into a frame. So take this business card here, for example. The actual content is separate from the surrounding frame. If we move the frame, content moves with it. The red line, by the way, is just a bleed guide and nothing to do with the frame or the content. However, if we select the icon in the center with the selection tool, we can move the actual content without moving the frame. At the corners, we can rotate the frame and content like so. If we adjust the frame in this way, it will crop the content without moving content itself. If we select the white arrow key, the direct selection tool, we move the content without moving the frame. So as you can see, frames and content are separate. Just remember the white arrows for the content and the black arrows for the frame. If we use the free transform tool, however, we can move and edit both the frame and the content at the same time. You can access the type tool here or simply press T on your keyboard. Then all you need to do is to click and drag to create a type box and then put in your text. Double click your text and then head up to the top to edit the layout like so. Here we can change the kerning and here we can edit the weight of the text. With the selection tool, as I mentioned before, we can edit the frame and move the text around. Notice how the magenta smart guides appear that tell us when something is aligned on the page to other objects. InDesign has the two rectangle tools. Remember I said that InDesign loves to use frames. One of them is a rectangle frame tool. When we make a rectangle with this tool, you'll have the X through the middle, like so. This basically lets us know that this box is for adding objects and content into it. For example, we can place a logo directly inside. Going back to what we learned about the selection tool, we can move the frame and the content, or just the logo itself. Also, you can add type directly into the frame rectangle. The regular rectangle tool acts like a rectangle tool in Illustrator. We can flick between a stroke and a fill. We can also type directly into this one too within InDesign. On the rectangle tool, if we hold down the click, we can access other shapes. Just like in Illustrator, we can use the pen tool to create shapes as well. You can even adjust the curves and anchor points with the direct selection tool, as we would do in Illustrator. If we make a shape with the rectangle tool, we can then add a gradient fill in this way. If you want to open up the gradient window, you can access it here. The gradient tool is located in the toolbar, and we're also able to add a gradient this way too. Hold down shift to keep a line perfectly straight. Then we can of course adjust the color of a gradient like so. Lastly, in this InDesign tutorial, if you take the scissors tool and click the edges of the shape, you can create a divide, essentially cutting the shape into separate parts. So did you find this InDesign tutorial on the essential tools of InDesign helpful? Let me know in the comment section below and be sure to subscribe for my 5 weekly graphic design uploads. Like and share this video, and until next time, design your future today. Peace.